Good day, students. Welcome to another lecture in economics. Today, we are going to look at perfect competition. So, let's define perfect competition. So, we are saying that perfect competition occurs when none of the individual market participants, example, the buyers or sellers, can influence the price of the product. So, the price is determined by the interaction of demand and supply, and all the participants have to accept that price. So, as we discussed earlier in our lesson, perfect competition is when businesses are selling the same products and they are actually price takers, and buyers and sellers, they both have complete information about the market. So we are saying that in perfectly competitive markets, all of the participants are therefore price takers, and they have to accept the price as given and can only decide what quantities to supply or demand at that price. So they don't actually have the power to change the price. If the tomatoes are $10 actually, and you want to come up with that business of selling tomatoes, you also just have to make your tomatoes $10. If the taxi fare is $12 and you want to get in the business of taxis, you just have to charge $12. And for customers, you just have to demand, you just have to pay for that price, right? So let's look at the requirements. So we said that the perfect competition exists if the following conditions are met, then you can say that no, the business or this business or this industry is actually perfect competition. So number one, there must be a large number of buyers and sellers of the product. So there should be a lot of people selling the same products, right? Number two, there must be no collusion between the sellers. So there should be no merging or combining businesses. There should be no collusion, colliding, combining, merging the businesses. All the goods sold in the market must be identical. So the products must be homogeneous. So to say that the business is operating in a perfect competition, so that industry should have, or the market should have, the same identical products, goods or services. There must be a complete freedom to entry and exit. It shouldn't be difficult to exit or to enter that market. All the buyers and sellers must have a perfect knowledge of the market condition. So you're saying that buyers and sellers, they should have all the information, or they should have all the knowledge about the product, the price, the quality, and so on. There must be no government intervention influencing buyers or sellers. And all the factors of production must be perfectly mobile. So it should be easier to get the factors of production or raw materials. Right. So let's look at the demand for the product of the firm. So you're saying that under perfect competition, the price of the product is determined by the supply and demand. As we say that no buyers or sellers have the ability to change the price. So the price is actually determined by the supply and the demand. We are saying that the individual firms in the is a price taker and can sell any quantity at the market price. So yeah, what we are saying is, if a firm operating under perfect competition is a price taker, they cannot decide on their on the price. All they have to do is to decide how many quantities they are going to sell. Under perfect competition, the individual firm is faced with a demand curve which is a horizontal or perfectly elastic at the existing market price. Right, so let's look at the demand curve for a product of the firm under perfect competition. So this is how a product under perfect competition looks like. You can see that you have the price here, which is actually equal to our average revenue and marginal revenue. Right. So we are saying that under perfect competition, the firm receives the same price of any number of units, the product that it sells, and its marginal revenue and average revenue are thus both equal to the market price. That's why we have this this line here. The price is equal to your average revenue and is equal to your marginal revenue. Then we know that the firm's total revenue is equal to the price multiplied by the quantity sold. So under perfect competition, the price is given this. For each additional unit that the firm sells, total revenue will increase by an amount equal to the price of the product. Right, so let's look at an example. We are saying that suppose a firm operates under conditions of perfect competition and that the market price of its product is 20 per unit. The firm is a price taker and its total revenue, its total average and marginal revenue for the first 5 units sold will be as follow. So you have quantity, you have price, you have total revenue, you have marginal revenue and average revenue. And in this case, we say that the price is equal to your marginal revenue and is equal to your average revenue. And your total revenue is here. Total revenue, we say that is quantity times price. So it will be 1 times 20, then you get 20. 2 times 20, you get 40. 3 times 20, you get 60. And you go on like that. Right, so this will take us to the end of our lesson for today. I hope you guys have enjoyed the lesson. And if you have any question, do not hesitate to contact me. I will see you guys in our next lesson.